We're back at PAX Unplugged 2019. I'm here with Chris Leader of Calliope Games. Now, you're premiering right now at this convention, Pseudo Phoenix Rising?
That's correct. So we announced this game at last year's PAX Unplugged, and this is the first public show where we've actually had the final game here available to the public to purchase. And we've been playing it, and you know, crowds have been coming by to check it all out. It's been really, really exciting.
So Pseudo is a well-known game in its own. So how is this a game different from the other? Is this an expansion? Is this its own game?
This is a fully new experience. It's its own standalone game. The original Pseudo is actually the flagship game that we started our company with, and it's what we consider to be one of the definitive gateway games. You know, 2 to 8 players can play it in 20 minutes, and it introduces people to a whole new concept in how to play games. So, you know, the main thing about Pseudo was going on, creating your path and staying on the board as long as you could. Well, in Pseudo Phoenix Rising, we took that foundation and we built a whole kind of new level on it. Because for years, we've had people say, I play Pseudo all the time. I kind of want a little bit more. You know, once they played it a lot, they say, I wish I could do a little bit more with this. Now, we do have Pseudo of the Seas that came out in 2012. That does dice. There's a chaotic element to that with the sea monsters and all that. With this one, we went a little bit more thinky. There's a little bit of a puzzle aspect to it. So you're still creating a path, and you're still moving, and you want to stay on the board. But the story of this one is that a vengeful god stole the stars out of the night sky long ago. So the people would send these paper lanterns up into the sky, these colorful lanterns, to give each other hope and a little bit of light in the evening. So these magical phoenixes appeared and would fly between them, and every time they touched them, they would make them into new stars in the night sky. So the mission of the game is to be a phoenix, fly around, and collect 7 stars and make a whole new constellation in the night sky. Now, what's different from regular Pseudo is played on a normal board, and you put tiles down. This game actually has double-sided tiles. One side has paths very much like the original Pseudo that go off the edges. This one has alternate sides that actually go off of the diagonal corners. So we have this patented tray board that you clip together, and this is designed so that with these tiles you can actually flip and rotate these without messing up any of the other tiles that are around it. So there's so many games out there where when you mess around with a tile, the whole square just goes all over the place.
Yeah.
We didn't want people messing around with that, so we created this tray tile that comes with the game, and it allows you to manipulate these tiles and create your path. So what you'll do is you'll have your phoenix will start on the edge. On your turn, you'll create your path in front of you. So I might add this, and I choose a path. I go along. When I leave a tile that has one of these glowing lanterns, I put a star on it, and I finish my movement. And then I move the lantern from the star with the tile with the star to a different one with the same color. And then I collect the star that I just made. I put it in front of me. The first person who collects 7 stars wins the game. So it's all about movement. Now, if I had stopped here in the middle of the board at a dead end, then on my next turn, I wouldn't have any tiles. Instead, what I would be doing is flipping and rotating this tile in front of me to create a new path and zoom along. When I do that, again, I create stars where I move things, move along, collect the star. So it's flipping, rotating, manipulating. You will be adding new tiles to the edges as well. So it still has that path building that the original Pseudo had, but it builds a whole puzzle aspect of flipping and rotating these tiles. And then, of course, the other thing, we all know phoenixes have the ability to burst into flames and come back, you know, rise from their ashes. Well, every player in this, when they start the game, they'll get one of these life tokens that looks like ashes. At any point during the game, let's say I have a board where all of the lanterns are on one side of the board, and I'm way the heck over here, it's gonna take me a while to get over there. So I may play a tile that actually sends me off the board. Now, people who played original Pseudo will gasp and go, what? Why would you do that? You're out of the game. Well, no, because on my next turn, I can spend my life token, I can pick a new location on the board, get new tiles, and come in an area that has more lanterns. But you can only do that once per game. Once your life token is out, it becomes like regular Pseudo. If you go off the board again, you're out. So there's one chance to rise from your ashes, and strategically, it can be good to actually send yourself off and come back in a better position. And sometimes it takes players a game to kind of get that under their belt because they're so conditioned to not going off the board. But once they understand that, it really opens up some new strategies for the game.
So if I was playing with you, could I move the tile so that it makes your journey difficult too?
Just like in regular Suro, you're always manipulating the path in front of your own pawn. However, if someone ended their turn here, and let's say I was there and you had ended your turn here, then sure enough, if I'm manipulating this tile right here, I might try to find something that, you know, if I had a tile in my hand, let's say we did something where we flipped this tile and I was able to send you off the board. Maybe there was something that wound you off and then I was able to continue on. I could affect your path that way. It's like the original Suro. When you're both going into the same location, what you do with that tile in the middle is going to affect the paths of multiple pawns. So that does exist. And if you like a little bit more player interaction, we do have in the rule book a variant, an advanced variant called the Winds of Change. What that is when you collect a lantern, if it's on a glowing space, because some of these have glowing and some of them have dim, you'll actually turn it to the dim side when you move it, and when you place it on another one, you'll actually turn it from the dark to the glowing side and place it. And that can be anywhere on the board, so you might affect somebody else on the other side of the board because of the way you flip that tile. So that's the advanced way. You know, when you're starting the game, that might be one step too far of thinking because you're getting used to the changes to Suro, but once you know the game and you can affect other areas of the board, it's a lot of fun.
Excellent. Well, this looks fantastic. This is released now.
Yes, this is available now.
And for those that couldn't make it to the convention today, where can they go pick this up?
This is available at friendly local game stores through distribution. You can also go to KalliopeeGames.com and you can check it out there. You can, if you can't find it near you, you can reach out to us on Twitter, Facebook, or through KalliopeeGames.com, and we can help find a store near you that carries it. We always support, you know, local game stores, and they have access to it at this point.